क्वेश्चन नंबर 23। फाइंड ऑल पॉइंट्स ऑफ डिसकंटिन्यूटी ऑफ एफ वेयर द फंक्शन इज साइन एक्स अपॉन एक्स इफ एक्स इज लेस देन जीरो एंड एक्स प्लस वन इफ एक्स इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल देन जीरो। इफ लेस देन जीरो द वैल्यू इज साइन एक्स अपॉन एक्स एंड ग्रेटर देन एंड इक्वल देन वन इट इज एक्स प्लस वन। नाउ चेक द कंटिन्यूटी ऑफ द फंक्शन। नाउ लेट अस चेक द कंटिन्यूटी एट एक्स इक्वल टू जीरो। ओके, फॉर x equal to 0. The limit when x tends to less than 0. The function is sin x upon x. So we can write h tends to 0. The sin minus h. The less than 0 is, suppose it is minus h. So minus sin h upon h equal to, it is equal to 1. Okay. Now, right hand limit, x tends to 0 positive of the function, the limit x tends to 0, we can write x plus 1, it is equal to 0 plus 1, 1. The left hand limit and right hand limit is also equal to 1. Now check function for x equal to 0, then x plus 1, it is equal to 1. The left hand limit equal to the right hand limit. Therefore, function is continuous at x equal to 0. At x is less than 0, the function sin x is all continuous function and x is also a continuous function. Therefore, sin x and x both are continuous and when x is less than 0. Both are continuous, therefore function is continuous. And the next, when x is greater than 0, it means the function is x plus 1. It means it is a polynomial. It is a polynomial. Polynomial is always continuous. Then the function f is continuous. Both the functions are continuous. Okay. So therefore the function f is continuous at any point. Okay. The question number 24. Determine if f defined by fx equal to x square sin 1 by x. If x is not equal to 0 and 0 if x equal to 0 is a continuous function. Check karna hai ki continuous hai ya nahi. Now the function is for the limit value, limit x tends to 0 of the function. Limit x tends to 0, x square sin 1 by x. It is also equal to 0. The value of this is equal to 0. And the function, when x equal to 0, the value of the function equal to 0. Therefore, the limit x tends to 0 of the function equal to the this. Therefore, function is continuous. Therefore, f is a continuous function. Or the f is continuous, right? Next question number 25. Examine the continuity of f where f is defined by fx equal to sin x minus cos x if x is not equal to 0 and minus 1 if x equal to 0. Now check that. Question number 25. Now check for at x equal to 0. Okay. Now the lower hand limit. Lower hand limit means limit x tends to 0 minus of the function. So we can write x equal to x minus h. Where x tends to 0, the function becomes h tends to 0, then the function is minus h. Okay, x equal to minus h. Now just put in the function. The function is sin x minus cos x. So put x equal to minus h. Now the value equal to sine 0, sine minus sine theta, it means sine 0 degree, minus cos minus theta, cos theta, it means cos 0 degree. It is equal to 0 minus 1. The answer is minus 1. Now the right hand limit, x tends to 0 positive. The same, just put x plus h. If x tends to 0, limit h tends to 0, function in the form of h. Right? The function is sin x means sin h minus cos h. Just put 0, sin 0 degree minus cos 0 degree. It is equal to also minus 1. This is 0 and minus 1. And f0, the function is at the 0 equal to minus 1. If x equal to 0, the value of the function is minus 1. It means lower hand limit and upper hand limit, it means lower hand limit, left hand limit and right hand limit equal to each other. Therefore, the function is continuous at x equal to 0. Continuous at x equal to 0. Okay. Question number 26. Find the values of k so that the function f is continuous at the indicated point of in exercise 26 to 29. Fx equal to k cos x pi minus 2x 3. If x is not equal to pi by 2. If x equal to pi by 2. Now check at x equal to pi by 2. Now find the values in the continuous question 26, 27, 28 and 29. Okay, now check x equal to pi by 2. It means the limit x tends to pi by 2 of the function equal to the f function. Okay, the limit x tends to pi by 2. The function is k cos x upon pi minus 2x. And the function at x equal to pi by 2, it is equal to 3. Limit x tends to pi by 2 equal to k cos x pi minus 2x equal to the function value is 3. Now find the value of this. Now take x equal to pi by 2 plus h. Okay. The limit h tends to 0. Okay. Now k cos pi by 2 plus h upon pi minus 2 into pi by 2 plus h. Now solve. Limit h tends to 0. It is k sin 90 plus theta equal to cos 90 plus theta equal to minus sin theta. It is minus sin h. Or divided by pi minus pi minus 2h. Multiplied by 2. Cancel. It means k by 2 common. Limit h tends to 0 means sin h minus sin h upon minus h. Okay. The limit minus minus cancel. Limit h tends to 0 sin h upon h equal to 1. It is k by 2 into 1. Now this value is equal to 3. Functional value is 3. So we can write k by 2 equal to 3. It is k equal to 2 into 3, 6. For k equal to 6, this function is continuous. Okay. Now question number 27. The function is kx square if x is less than equal than 2 and 3 if x is greater than 2. It is continuous at x equal to 2. Therefore, the limit value x tends to 2 minus of the function and limit x tends to 2 plus right hand limit equal to the value of the function. It is continuous at 2, it means this will be equal. Okay, now take first f2. When x equal to 2, the function is kx square. K x square means k into 2 square. It is 4k. Okay, the left hand limit of the function, it means kx square. It is equal to the 4k. And the limit, left hand limit negative x is less than 2 when it is kx square, and then right hand positive side limit of the function, it is equal to 3. When x is greater than 2, the value is 3. Now for the value 4k equal to 3, it is equal to k equal to 3 by 4. At x equal to 2, it is continuous, therefore 4k equal to 3 equal to 4k. All the three values are equal. Therefore, k equal to 3 by 4. Okay. Now, question number 28. The question number 28 is, the function kx plus 1, if x is less than equal than pi, and cos x if x is greater than pi, it is continuous at the point x equal to pi. Okay, it is continuous x equal to pi. When x equal to pi, the function is kx plus 1. When x equal to pi, at x equal to pi, this is equal to, now put x equal to pi, it is equal to the pi x plus 1. Okay, now take limit. Limit when x tends to pi negative of the function. It means x is less than pi, it is kx plus 1. Therefore, k pi plus 1. For pi, here is k pi plus 1. Okay. At the right hand side, when pi is greater than x, x is greater than pi, the value is cos x. Cos x means limit x tends to pi. It is cos pi. The value of cos pi equal to minus 1. Okay. According to the question, it is continuous. F is continuous at x equal to pi. Therefore, the limit value of the function equal to the right hand limit equal to the left hand limit equal to the function itself. The same thing, it means k pi plus 1 equal to minus 1. Now k pi equal to 2, minus 1, it is minus 2, and k equal to minus 2 upon pi. K equal to minus 2 upon pi. Okay. The function is given that kx plus 1 if x is less than equal than 5, and 3x minus 5 is if x is greater than 5. It is continuous at x equal to 5. It is continuous at x equal to 5. Therefore, the left hand limit equal to the right hand limit and equal to the function itself. Okay. Now just put x equal to 5. When in this form, less than 5, this one, it means the limit less than x is less than 5 means the function is kx plus 1. And when x is greater than 5, the function is 3x minus 5. And the function value f5. X equal to 5 means this. It is equal to 5k plus 1. And it is 3 into 5 minus 5. And it is also equal to 3 into 5 plus 1. इट इज अ 5 kx plus 1, ओ सॉरी 5 k plus 1. नाउ सॉल्व, 5 k plus 1 इक्वल टू 15 minus 5 10, 5 k equal to 10 minus 1 9, इट मीन्स k इक्वल टू 9/5. दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ k फॉर विच द x इक्वल टू 5 द फंक्शन इज कंटिन्यूअस. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 30. क्वेश्चन नंबर 30 इज फाइंड द वैल्यूज ऑफ a एंड b सच दैट द फंक्शन डिफाइंड बाई 5 इफ x इज लेस देन इक्वल देन 2, ax प्लस b इफ x इज लेस x इज ग्रेटर देन 2 बट लेस देन 10 एंड 21 इफ x इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल देन 10. इट इज ए कंटिन्यूअस फंक्शन. इट इज ए कंटिन्यूअस फंक्शन. ओके, इट इज ए कंटिन्यूअस फंक्शन एट फॉर द ऑल रियल नंबर्स. इट इज कंटिन्यूअस फॉर ऑल रियल नंबर्स. इन पर्टिकुलर केस इफ इट्स x इक्वल टू 2 एंड x इक्वल टू 10 इट इज कंटिन्यूअस. x इक्वल टू 2 एंड x इक्वल टू 10 इट इज कंटिन्यूअस. इफ फर्स्ट पार्ट, इफ f इज कंटिन्यूअस एट x इक्वल टू 2, फर्स्ट पार्ट. ओके, नाउ टेकिंग द लिमिट, एट द 2 राइट हैंड एंड लेफ्ट हैंड एंड द फंक्शन वैल्यू एट. Okay, so now x is less than 2, it is equal to, x is less than 2 means it is 5, okay, and when greater than 2, the function is, x is greater than 2, it is ax plus b, and at x equal to 2, it is equal to 5, okay. This is equal to the 5 equal to ax plus b. It means a into 2 plus b. The first equation is 2a plus b equal to 5. This is the first equation, 2a plus b equal to 5. Now at x equal to 10, okay, the particular case taken, x equal to 2 and x equal to 10. The function at lower limit, left hand limit, right hand limit of the function equal to 21. X is equal to f, you can write here f x, not write direct, it is f x. Now x is less than 10, it is ax plus b, it means ax plus b. When x is greater than 10, it is equal to 21 and the function value is also 21. Now it is equal to 10a plus b equal to 21. This is the second equation. Now we can solve first and second equation. 2a plus b equal to 5. Multiply the whole equation by 5. We get 10a plus 5b equal to 25. Now subtract the equation second from this. Subtract 2 from 3 minus 4b equal to 4. It means 4b equal to 4, b equal to 1. Now put the value of b equal to 1 in any equation. 10a plus b equal to 21. Now put b equal to 1. 10a equal to 20 and a equal to 2. The answer is a equal to 2 and b equal to 1, for which this function is continuous function. If a equal to 2 and b equal to 1, therefore, this function is continuous. Now, question number 31. show that the function defined by fx equal to cos x square is a continuous function. Okay, we have to show the cos x square is a continuous function. The fx equal to cos x square, it is a complex function. We have to prove it is a continuous function. So there is a composition of two functions, cos and then x square. Suppose g operation h, where gx equal to cos x and h function is x square. There are two functions, g and h. So we have to prove that the cos x is continuous and x square is also continuous function. Okay. Now first we have to prove that gx equal to cos x. It is a continuous function. Okay. So you can write g of h, g operation h, x. It is equal to the g operation function hx. Now gh, g, it is x square. Hx equal to x square. And the g operation x square means cos x square. This is the fx. Okay. This is the function. Now first prove gx equal to cos x is continuous. Take x equal to c is any point on the real line. Therefore we can write gc equal to cos c. The function becomes x equal to c, the gc equal to cos c. Now put x equal to x plus, x equal to c plus h. X equal to c plus h. If x tends to c, therefore h equal to, h tends to 0. X equal to c plus h, x tends to c, h tends to 0. Now limit x tends to c of the function. It means x tends to c cos c. Now x tends to c, so we can write limit h tends to 0 cos c plus h. Okay. X tends to c, this function is cos x c plus h. Now expand the formula of cos a plus b. It is a cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. Now take limit h tends to 0. You will get cos c cos 0 minus sin c into sin 0. Cos 0 equal to 1. The value is cos c. This will equal to 0. Cos x equal to, it means the limit function equal to the function function. It means continuous. Limit at x tends to c of the function equal to the function itself. Therefore, cos c is continuous. Okay. Now, the second function, same the, suppose h or the any real number on the this. The first second function is hx equal to x square. Now we have to prove hx equal to x square is a continuous function. Take x equal to k. Suppose x equal at x equal to k, the function is k square. Now the limit x tends to at k. Okay, now x tends to k, it is equal to the hx limit x tends to k x square, it is equal to k square. Therefore, the limit value of the function equal to the function itself at the point k. At point k, we can say at the point k. Therefore, h is a continuous function. H is a continuous function and g is a continuous function. Therefore, cos c is continuous means g is also a continuous function. तो वी कैन से दैट द ऑपरेशन एफ एक्स, देयरफॉर एफ एक्स इक्वल टू जी ऑपरेशन एच एक्स, इट मीन्स कॉस एक्स स्क्वायर इज ए कंटिन्यूअस फंक्शन. Yes, we have to prove cos x and x square is continuous. Show that the function defined by fx equal to mod value of cos x is a continuous function. Okay. The function fx equal to this. This is also a combination of two functions, g and h. Here is the g and h, two functions of x variable. So we can write g of the operation hx. Okay, now we can write hx is cos x, hx is the cos x, and the final function is mod cos x, it is equal to the function of x. So now first we have to prove that the cos x is continuous. So we all know in the previous question we have already proved that the cos x is a continuous function. Just in the second, in this we have to prove gx equal to mod x. This is a continuous function. This can be written in the form of minus x if x is less than 0 and x if x is greater than and equal than 0. The mod value of this can be written as, now g is a certified for all real numbers. Okay, g is certified for all real numbers, it is equal. Let c be a real number, any real number on the real line. Now case 1, the first case is x c is less than 0. If c is less than 0 means it is equal to minus x. If c is 0, 0 means function equal to minus c. And the limit value x tends to c of gx, it is equal to the minus x equal to minus c. The function value and limit value is equal. It means it is continuous at c is less than 0. We can write g is continuous at all points, at all points x such that x is less than 0. Now take second point, case 2, when c equal to 0 or the c is greater than 0. Case 2 we can take c is greater than 0. Now the function value gc equal to c and the limit value it is also equal to c. Then it is equal to, we can write limit x tends to c function x equal to c. Clearly g is continuous. Again g is continuous at all points x such that x is greater than 0. Next, the case 3 is x equal to 0. Now third case we can take x equal to 0. Now the function gx equal to 0, at x equal to 0, 0, and limit x tends to 0 of the function, this one is also equal to 0. So we can write the function value at इट मीन्स इट इज g इज कंटिन्यूस एट x इक्वल टू जीरो, कंटिन्यूस एट, वी कैन से द जी एक्स इज कंटिन्यूस, जी इज ए कंटिन्यूस फंक्शन एंड एच एक्स इक्वल टू कॉस एक्स. तो वी हैव ऑलरेडी प्रूव्ड इन द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन कॉस एक्स इज ए कंटिन्यूस फंक्शन, कॉस एक्स इज ए कंटिन्यूस फंक्शन. यू कैन प्रूव लाइक क्वेश्चन नंबर 31. Therefore, the function mod of cos x is continuous for all points. The question number 33, examine that the sine mod x is a continuous function. Okay, the sine mod x is a continuous function. Fx equal to sine mod x. This function fx is the combination of two functions. It is a composition of two functions because it is defined for the all real numbers. Okay, so now we can write g of h, the function. It is a composition of two functions, g and h. So we can write hx. G is the function of hx. Now hx is the sine x. It is equal to the sine x function. And g sine x equal to mod of sine x. The function is sine mod x. This is the function of fx. Now first we have to prove that the gx is continuous. So let gx equal to mod x. Gx equal to mod x. It can be written in the form of gx equal to minus x and x. When x, if x is less than 0 and if x is greater than equal than 0. Like the same last question, question number 32, we have proved that the gx equal to mod x, it is a continuous. Like this, let c be a real number. First case c is less than 0, then the function of c equal to minus c and gx equal to limit a minus c. Same process you can prove like this. Okay. Yeah, up to this line. G is continuous at x equal to 0. Same process. You can just upload the same part here and you can say gx is continuous. Okay. Just like the second part. Second part of this is sine x. Okay. You can write sine x. The function is sine x. Like hx equal to the function sine x. But the c is a point on this. We can write sine c. The function h in the form of c equal to the function sine c. Just we can write limit x tends to c. Okay, the limit x tends to c hx equal to, we can write limit x tends to c sine x. Just put x equal to c plus k. Okay, so x tends to c, it means k tends to 0. X tends to c, then it means k tends to 0. So we can write limit k tends to 0 sine c plus k. Okay. So now sine a plus b, the formula of sine a plus b is equal to sine a, it means sine c cos k plus cos c sine k. Now take the limits. Sine c cos k means cos 0 plus cos c then sine 0. The sine 0 is 0, this part is 0, cos 0 equal to 1, the value is, it is equal to sine c. Now the limit x tends to c, the function value equal to gc. The function value is also sin c and this. Therefore, h is a continuous function. G is continuous and h is continuous function. We know that the all real valued function g and h. G of h is defined at c. If g is continuous, h is continuous, therefore the function fx is also continuous. Fx is continuous because h and g are continuous. Okay. Next and last question, number 34. Find all the points of discontinuity of f defined by fx equal to mod x minus mod x plus 1. Okay, all the points of discontinuity. Okay. Fx equal to mod x minus mod x plus 1. Take the two functions, gx equal to mod x and hx equal to mod x plus 1. F equal to g minus h. If g is continuous, h is continuous, therefore f is also continuous. Now first we have to prove that gx equal to mod x. So now gx can be written in the form of minus x and x. We have already proved mod x is continuous in the question number 32. Okay. The same x is less than 0 if x is greater than equal than 0. Now g is clarified for all the point of a real line x equal to c. So c be any real number. C be any real number. Now take case number 1. The case 1 is x is less than 0. X is less than 0 means c is less than 0. The function of c equal to minus x means minus c. X is less than 0, c is less than 0, the function value is minus c. Now limit x tends to c, the function equal to minus c. Okay, x tends to c, the function minus x, it is minus c. The limit value x tends to c of the function equal to the function itself. Therefore, g, not the function, it is g. It means g is continuous. G is continuous at x, c is less than 0. For g, is c is less than 0. Now, the case number 2. When c equal to 0, the c equal to 0, now g c equal to 0 and limit c tends to 0, the gx, it is equal to the x is equal to 0, it is x. Therefore, limit c tends to 0, it is equal to 0. And then next, limit c tends to 0, the function value equal to the function itself, it means it is gc. It is continuous at c equal to 0. G is continuous at c equal to 0. Now the case 3 is, third case is c is greater than 0. Okay, the c is greater than 0, it means the gx equal to x, gx equal to x here. Therefore, the value gc equal to c. Okay. Now, limit value. It is also c. The limit value of function equal to the function itself. Therefore, g is continuous at c is greater than 0. इट मीन्स जी इज कंटिन्यूअस फॉर ऑल, जी इज कंटिन्यूअस फॉर ऑल पॉइंट्स, ऑल पॉइंट्स एक्स सच दैट एक्स इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल देन लेस देन ऑल द जीरो. नाउ द सेकेंड फंक्शन इज एफ एक्स इक्वल टू, नाउ आई विल सॉल्व हियर. नाउ द सेकेंड फंक्शन एच एक्स इक्वल टू मॉड वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स प्लस वन, ओके द मॉड वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स प्लस वन. तो दिस फंक्शन कैन बी रिटन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ माइनस एक्स प्लस वन एंड एक्स प्लस वन, पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव. नेगेटिव व्हेन इफ एक्स इज लेस देन, एक्स इज लेस देन माइनस वन, एंड पॉजिटिव व्हेन एक्स इज ग्रेटर देन एंड इक्वल देन माइनस वन. एक्स प्लस वन ये एक्स इक्वल टू माइनस वन, लेस देन माइनस वन दिस वैल्यू एंड ग्रेटर देन दिस. लेट सी बी एनी पॉइंट, सी बी ए रियल नंबर, ओके द सेम केस वन. द केस वन इज इफ सी इज लेस देन माइनस वन, द वैल्यू ऑफ फंक्शन इज इक्वल टू माइनस सी प्लस वन, ओके एंड द लिमिट एक्सटेंड्स टू सी, द एच एक्स इक्वल टू इट विल ऑल्सो इक्वल टू सी प्लस वन, ओके देयरफॉर लिमिट एक्सटेंड्स टू सी ऑफ द फंक्शन इक्वल टू द फंक्शन. It means the h is continuous at all points such that x is less than minus 1. You can write h is continuous at all points x such that x is less than minus 1. Okay. Now case 2. Second case. If c is greater than minus 1, then function in the form of c, it is equal to x plus 1. It means x plus 1 means c plus 1. And the limit value, x tends to c of the h x. This will also equal to c plus 1. Okay, x equal to c, it means c plus 1. Therefore, limit it is equal to this. Again, we can write h is continuous at all points, same line, all points x such that x is greater than minus 1. Now the case number 3, when 0, case number 3, if c is equal to 0, the c is equal to 0, the h x equal to x plus 1, x plus 1, then c equal to, it is equal to x is equal to there, the value is minus 1. Okay. If c equal to, sorry, 0 not, c equal to minus 1, not the 0. C equal to minus 1. Then h c equal to h minus c. It is equal to minus 1 plus 1, it is equal to 0. Now limit x tends to c minus 1. Okay. Then the function value minus value is equal to minus x plus 1. Okay, the minus x plus 1. It is also equal to same minus, minus 1 plus 1, 0. And the positive the limit x tends to, it is equal to x plus 1. Therefore, x tends to minus 1. C tends to minus 1. It is एच एक्स माइनस वन प्लस वन इज इक्वल टू जीरो. Therefore, the limit value both are same. This is equal to, it means h is continuous at x equal to minus 1. The h is continuous at the minus 1, less than minus 1, greater than minus 1. It means above three observation we can conclude that h is continuous of the all points. Therefore, h is continuous at all points. Okay, and g is also continuous for all points. Therefore, function f equal to g minus h is continuous for all points. For continuous at all points, not the for at all points. Okay, there is no point of discontinuity. There is no point of discontinuity. In this question, we have to find the point of discontinuity. Therefore, in this question, there is no point of continuity because when greater than 0, less than 0, equal to 0 is continuous. Less than minus 1, greater than minus 1, equal to minus 1, also continuous. So therefore, no point of discontinuity. Thank you.